Hi friends, a very good morning. Welcome you all back to the Do It With Me series 2. Friends, as you all know, in this case study, I'm going to work with the Tally D book. Why I have chosen this topic? Because now audit is going on and we are going to work with the Tally data very soon for tax audits and other audits. Generally, when we download the Tally day book into the Excel format using the export option, it will not come into the proper format for the analysis. That is the reason in today's session, my concentration for next 1.5 hour is simply how to use the day book properly into the Excel. I'll just wait for another 1 minute. In the meanwhile, I request everyone to download the RAR file, which I'm going to work on in today's session by going into the website Excelism. I request you to just simply go to www.excelism.in/YouTube. You please visit this website and download the RAR file so that we all can work together. I'm going to keep the same into the chat box of the live. So I request everyone, please download the material first. Hi, good morning, Ramakrishna. Good morning, Srikant, Dhanush. I request all the participants to download the RAR file for today's case study by visiting the website excelism.in/YouTube. Let me also open the same. /YouTube. You can simply go here and click download. You will get the zip file. I request you to work with the zip file. And also I request you to extract the zip file. And you'll find a file called rawfile-daybook. Friends, don't worry. After the session, the answer file I'll upload into the same website. So you need not to worry. So after the session, I'll upload the same file into the website, so you need not to worry. Friends, don't worry. I hope everyone downloaded the file. That's most important. Whoever just joined into the session, I request you to please visit the website excelism.in/. I'm also keeping the same thing into the chat box. Today's session from Excelism.in. Great. Okay. So let me directly go into the file. Friends, once you open the file, this is the file you will get it. But let me also tell you how to export this file from the Tally, because I have directly given the Excel file for all of you, but also let me give you the step how to download this from the Tally. So let me open the Tally application from my Excel, from my system. I'm using tally.erp9. You can find the version here. My version is 6.4.9, right? So you can select the company. Let me click enter so that it will take me to the select company. As you all know, if I want to go back, you can use shift tab so that you will be into the path, right? So in the path, I need to put the password. So I have a Tally data for which I have already downloaded actually, but let me copy this, control C. Friends, these are all steps you need not to do, because I have already given you the Excel file directly. But for the people who doesn't know how to download this file from the Tally, I'm just trying to give a small demonstration. Let me enter. Once I click enter, this is the company Saran Kumar and LLP. You go to the display, just click D because this is the key which is highlighted. In that, go to the daybook. Now let me select F2, Alt F2, because I need to select the dates. 1/4/2019 till 31st March 2020. You can type it so that all the entries you can find here. Okay, if you observe 2, 4, 5, 6 entries are there. So what I'll be doing, I have to export this. Let me click this export. Friends, in the Tally, when you find any key having a underscore, that means with the alt combination, you can use it. When any key you find with the double underline, that means with the control combination you can use, because it's an export, under E there is an underline. That means I need to use Alt plus E together. It is directly asking me to export by default, that will get export into the XML format, right? But I have to get this into the Excel format. So what I'll be doing, because this is the last step, but if I want to go back to the previous step, shift tab, go to the shift tab. By default, it will select the default all languages. Let this be XML data interchange, but I don't want to download this into XML. Let me take it into Excel. Then it is asking where you want to export this file. Whoever just joined, let me tell you, this is just a small demonstration I'm trying to give you how to download the book, daybook from the Tally to the Excel. I've already given you the raw file into the Excel. I hope you all are following. We have to go into the demonstration of the Excel file conversion into the proper format. Okay. Now let me give a path. I want to give a path, the same path, Control C. As you know, the shortcut is Control Alt V. Now let me enter. So it's going to open the file name as a daybook, the sheet name as a daybook. Do you want to open the file? No, I don't want. Do you want the formatting here? Yes. You can put everything, yes, wherever it is possible. I don't want to have a condensed one. I want to have a detailed one, so that before conversion into the proper Excel format, I can analyze what items are there. It is asking, do you want the voucher numbers? Yes. Do you want the narrations? Yes. Though in our today's topic, I'm not going to talk much about the narrations, but narrations are one of the very important one through which you can do a lot of analysis. Do you want bill-wise transaction? Wherever it is possible, just try to keep S. Once you keep all S, it is exporting your daybook into the Excel. It will take little time because in my case, more than 3,500 records are there. It is just trying to upload, updating the row numbers. Leave this part. Once you get the Excel file, this is the way it looks like. I request all the participants, please open the raw file which I have given. Let me reiterate. Let me just close my Twitter. Yeah. So let me reiterate. You can go to the excelism.in/YouTube, where you can find today's raw file. If you want to go back for the previous session, you can even download the Do It With Me series 1 download file. Let me go back to my Excel. Friends, this is the blank Excel file. As you all know, generally I don't directly work with the raw file. So let me close this file with save. Let me go back to my folder. Let me go back, because raw data, let me keep it into the same way. Control C, Control V. Now let me change the name as a working file, right? So that this file I'm going to upload later into the same website. This will have all the steps what I'm going to follow. Let me just check it out whether, because I am managing my YouTube also. So I just want to see, are there any questions so that I can answer, right? So this is the raw data. Let me delete this sheet one because this is not required as of now. Friends, this data is not ready with me for the analysis. I cannot do great analysis out of this data. So what I'll be doing, I will do some cleaning up activity so that I'll make this data in such a way so that I can do some analysis on this, so that I can do some audit on this. So as you all know, I don't directly work on the raw data, because if something goes wrong, it will be a little difficult for me to retrieve the data back. So what you need to do, you can simply right click, move or copy, create a copy. You can just select move to the end. So what this step will do, it's going to create one more sheet with the same data. Otherwise, simply you just try to drag with your mouse. Are you finding there is a small document symbol along with my cursor? Yes. When you are finding a document symbol, that means it is a moving. When you hold the control key, are you finding a plus symbol also coming along with my cursor? When you hold the control key, plus is coming, that means you want to create a copy. In this case, I want to create a copy. Let me just keep here. So are you finding your raw data? This is just the copy of the same sheet. Let me rename this as working file. Okay, I request everyone, please copy paste the same sheet into the next sheet and rename as working file. Please don't copy the content and paste into the next sheet. Just copy and paste the entire sheet. I hope my instructions are very clear. See, still my tally data is trying to exporting. It's okay. Once it is done, I can open the tally. As of now, let me just look into the Excel file. Right? Friends, whenever you download the daybook, first two items are, what is the title of this book? This is a daybook. And what is the period? I don't want these two as of now. Select the A1 cell, shift space. It is always a good practice to know the shortcuts, which makes my work simple. So shift space, which can select the entire row. Otherwise, you simply click on the title of the row. Then shift down arrow so that both rows will get selected. Now you can use a shortcut control minus. Control minus is the shortcut to delete. Otherwise, simply right click on the title. Are you finding delete? Just delete. That is the first step I am doing. I request everyone, just follow with me. Don't worry, I'll not go slow. Let me reiterate the step what I have done. I've just selected first two rows, right click, you'll find delete. Otherwise, you can use an option control minus. Otherwise, you can even find a home tab here, in that you can even click delete. Anything is fine. Any of the three options you can use. I'll give 1 minute time here. I just deleted the title rows. Whoever just joined into the session, friends, please download the material from excelism.in/YouTube. I already kept the same thing in the chat box. Great. After you remove the first two rows, filters is the one which make my work more simple. So what I'll be doing, keep the cursor in the A1 cell. Everyone, please keep the cursor in the A1 cell. There is a shortcut called Control Shift End. Control plus Shift plus End. Let me give the shortcuts here so that you can all practice later. Friends, shortcuts are something which you cannot learn by just by hearting, but you can only learn by practicing. So today I have used the shortcut Control plus minus symbol. So you may confuse the here Control plus minus. Control plus means it's a combination key, remove rows, delete either a cell or a row or a column. And I have used one more shortcut, Shift plus space to select entire row. And I have used one more shortcut, Control plus Shift plus End. The shortcut selects the entire range, right? So entire user range rather. Okay, let me keep the cursor here. Control Shift End, right? Control Shift End. I'm sorry, 1 second. Let me just go here, go to the home, Control Shift End. So if you observe, it has selected the entire data. You can go to the data tab. You can just click filter. Filter is something which is amazing, very beautiful feature through which we can do a lot of analysis. You can just click the filter. Or else the shortcut for the filter, we have already seen Control plus Shift plus L. I hope you all observed when I kept the cursor here, you can find the same Control plus Shift plus L. Apply filter. There is one more shortcut to apply filter, Alt-DFF. Okay, this is also the same. Any of the shortcut you can use. Now, if you go to the A1 cell, my filters apply. Many people go wrong because they just select the first row and they started giving applying the filters, but that is a very wrong habit. If you select only the first row and apply the filter, till wherever range continued, till the point only it will take into the consideration for the filters. So what I have done, I kept my cursor here. I did Control Shift End. So it has selected my entire data. Go to the data, give the filter. Let me just give the filter. That's all. If you want to do the cleanup activity properly, first you need to understand how this file is looking like, right? Friends, I don't know how many of you worked with the SAP data or any of the bigger ERP data. If you download their orchards, every transaction is having a document number. Document number means a unique number allocated for every entry posted into the SAP or any ERP. That document number for us in the tally is a voucher number. But this voucher number is unique for each voucher type. It's not a sequential number. And also, it will not be very good because many a times people don't use it properly. Friends, here number 3 got missed. I request you to just put 3. Are you finding here there is a purchase? Besides that number got missed, I request you to keep number 1. While I was just copying and pasting, it got deleted because it's a purchase voucher, first voucher number. I request you to fill H10 with 1. Okay. So my first target here is to remove the unnecessary data. How to remove the unnecessary data? It's very simple. First, these 4 columns I don't want. I request everyone to select from C column till F column. You can select it. You can just select by using the mouse, or else you can just select with the shortcut Control space, which can select the entire column. Shift right arrow, right arrow, right arrow. Now I request you to delete this because this data is not required to me. Just delete. Let me repeat this step. I have selected from C column till F column, C, D, E, F. Just select from C column till F column, right click, delete. Everyone, please follow the same steps so that you may not go wrong a little later. Sabari ma'am, I have already kept the file into the excelism.in/YouTube. I request you to go to this URL where you can find the raw data. Friends, whoever just joined, I request you to please visit the website, download the raw file. In that zip file, you will find one Excel file. Just open the file, remove the first two rows, then keep the filters. I removed from the C column till F column. It's okay, ma'am. I'll wait for another 1 minute. I'm just waiting 1 minute for you to complete the steps. Let me do all the steps very quickly for all of you, everyone. Friends, first two rows I have deleted. Then here there is one number which got merged. I kept 1 year. Then I selected from the C column till the F column. I have deleted because this data is not required to me. Right? Now, below the titles, amount column is there. This is not required. So what I'll be doing, I'll select this row. I'll delete this. Everyone select the second row along with me. Please do with me. Select the second row, delete this. Great. Now friends, in the tally, one voucher can have minimum two line items that can be debit and credit, or else debit can be more than one line item, or else sometimes credit can be more than one line item, or else sometimes debit will be five line items, credit also will be five line items. So what I'll be doing, I'll just filter for debit. This is the first important step, everyone. Please filter for debit. Unselect everything. You click select all. This is nothing but deselect. Come to the end. Just keep the cursor to the end. Select the blanks. Click OK. I just filtered the blanks from the debit column. I just filtered the blanks from the debit column. Sir, it's okay. We will not consider any of the purchase voucher number. You can ignore that. There's one more question. If you go with you simultaneously, neither we do completely or nor you see your steps. So, sir, that's the reason I'm giving you the time. Please go ahead. Sir, this is a very sample data I have prepared for the session. So, voucher numbers are not very much relevant. Don't worry. Verma sir, that's the reason I'm giving little time. Leave about the voucher numbers. Somewhere it might have missed. It's not very important column for us. Please select blanks from the debit column. If you think I'm going a little faster, probably you can request me in the chat box so that I will go a little slow. In fact, at every step, I'm giving 1 minute time. Sir Verma, sir, you can just go slow, no problem. My intention is by the end of the today's session, you also should complete this assignment along with me. In fact, the entire concept of do it with me is same. No worries. So after filter the debits for blanks, let me filter credit also for blanks. Go to the end of the filter, select the blanks. Let me click OK. I feel this data is the junk data. I feel this data is the junk data. Now what I'll be doing, I'll keep the cursor here. I'll do Control Shift End because I want to delete this data. To delete the rows or columns or cells, I've already given one shortcut, Control Minus. Either you can do Control Minus, or you can right click and delete, or you can go to the Home tab and click Delete. Sir, leave about the voucher number. Sai Manikatta, I request you, please leave about the voucher number, because voucher number anyway we are going to delete later. Voucher type is the one which we are going to consider in today's session. I'll give one more tip for the members who are finding problem of keeping both the screens one after other. The tip which I would like to give you, I'm sure you may be watching from your laptop, obviously, or computer. You can just click this. This is what the screen you are finding. Then you can put the Excel here. You can little minimize. This is the one which can minimize or restore. So you can just keep half of this part. While you are watching, you can do the steps. This is probably one tip which I can suggest. Okay, so that is the way you can just go ahead. I'm just doing couple of steps, Control Z, so that I can do it again. Whoever missed, let me do Control Z, Control Z, Control Z, Control Z. Friends, I have deleted all these four columns. Whoever missed the steps, please follow me. After that, I removed the second row. You can just check it out whether you are doing the same. After that, I filtered for the blanks. Let me go to the end, select this. After that, I need to filter the blanks again from the credits. Go to the end, select the blanks. Till here, I have explained. Now keep the cursor into the A4 cell. Control Shift End. Control Shift End will select the visible cells from the starting point till the last used cell. You can simply go to the Home tab. You can click Delete. Once you click Delete, it will ask for a pop-up. Do you want to delete the entire row? I can simply click OK so that all selected areas, rows will get deleted. Now remove the filter, go to the data, clear the filter. I request everyone to do the same steps. Let me undo the steps again. After I filtered blanks from debit column and credit column, I kept the cursor at A4 cell. I have used a shortcut to select till the last row. Control Shift End from the keyboard. When I say Control plus Shift plus End, that means all the keys together you have to use. Then I have used a shortcut Control minus, or else you can right click on the area. You can delete, or else you can go to the Home tab. You can delete. Any of these three options you can use. Let me click Delete. Once you click Delete, it will ask for a question. Do you want to delete the entire sheet row? Click OK. Right? So it has deleted all the selected area, all the selected rows. Now you can keep any of the place on the top row. You can go to the data tab. You can, are you finding there is an option here, clear? Click clear so that the filters will be cleared. I'm sure till here, everyone are with me. I only request you, if you think that this session is also important to your article students or maybe your colleagues or someone maybe you care much, you can just forward this link to them so that even they join now, they can follow up. Don't worry, whoever missing one or two steps from the session, this video will be live again. This video will be there in the same channel. You can go through even later. Okay, so now let me go to the last column, G column. I'm going to have a title, DR Ablexia. Debit, credit, I want to keep it into the same column so that I can have a control every time whether my entry is having zero balance or not. That means the entire debits and credits put together, zero must be there. That control I want to have. A very simple function. I'm going to write here a simple formula equal to is an indication for the Excel that I'm writing the formula. E2 minus F2. Simple formula I have written for the last column. The advantage of this is when there is a value in the debit, you will get a positive. When there is a value in the credit, you will get the negative. Nowhere we'll find both debit and credit on the same row. So obviously for one line item, I'll not have debit and credit both. So one row will always have either debit or credit. Considering that as a logic, I've taken debit minus credit. Everyone please write this formula. Last column, which I'm creating new. Let me enter. Select this. Just keep the cursor at the corner, right side edge down. Once you double click, the same formula will be copy pasted till the end. No problem. This is by default giving me the two decimal. Go to the home tab, keep the comma format with the zero decimal. Friends, sometimes you'll not find the plus symbol here. In fact, in the last session also I have covered, let me reiterate, go to the file tab, go to the options, go to the advanced. This problem might have unchecked. You need to check this box. Let me do the same steps what I have done earlier. Friends, last column I kept column title as a DR /CI. I have written a formula here equal to this minus this. Let me just copy paste this everywhere. Go to the home tab, keep the comma format with zero decimal. Now let me show you the formula. Here I'm just giving 1 minute break in the sense for you to complete the job. Then I can continue. I request members to complete till here. Great. Let me enter. Now, friends, this is the new column I have created. This will be very much helpful. You will get to know it later. Now, go to the first row, first column. Right now you can just double click this because this column width is so much so that we can adjust the column width. I request everyone to insert a new column as a first column. How to insert a new column? You can just select the first column, right click, and you can just click insert. This is very important step. Here we are going to have the document number, unique document number. Don't keep the title. I'll tell you why you should not keep the title now. Friends, my job is, I feel this is one of the very important step. Let me select this step. Let me keep this into the separate call color so that you can understand what exactly it is. Everyone, just give me 1 second. Let me keep this into the separate color so that you can understand why this is most important. Friends, wherever an entry continued, here this entry is having 2 line items. This transaction, I want to keep it as a 1. And here also it continued for 2 line items. I want to keep 2 here. Here it continued for 5 line items. I want to keep this number as a 3, because it's a 3rd transaction. I want to keep here as a 4. I want to keep here as a 5, 6, 7, and so on. So I want to have a unique transaction number here. One of the very important formula, I request you to stop for a minute. First, let me complete this formula so that you can do the same in your system. I'll keep my cursor here. Don't keep any title here, please. Equal to. Friends, I can write a small conditional function here. That is if function. What is the function I need to write here? It's very simple. If this cell, that means the cell in the B column is having blank. If the cell in the B column, let me little zoom in. I'm just trying to zoom little in so that this will be visible for everyone. Please concentrate. Equal to if B column cell is equal to blank. As you all know, for the blank, we keep open double quote, close double quote. If B column is a blank, that means what is the meaning of it? That means above value, I should repeat. So, comma. If this logical test is true, please take the above cell. I request everyone to first listen this formula, understand, then you can put into your Excel. If B column value is blank, then repeat the above cell value. If it is not a blank value, if false, if this logical test is false, above value plus 1. I hope everyone understood the logic of this. The logic is very simple. If it is having a date, that means a new transaction is appearing. That means the transaction number has to increase. I'm just taking above cell plus 1. If it is not a date, that means if it is a blank, that means the same transaction is continuing. So whatever the above cell, please continue. If I enter, since B2 cell is not a blank, it will take above cell plus 1. Above cell is a blank, blank plus 1 is my answer is 1. Now let me just copy and paste below. What is your answer? Still 1. Why? Because this cell is a blank cell, above value I'm taking. Now if I copy and paste below, can anyone put in the chat box what is the answer for this? If I copy and paste this below, can you please put in the chat box? Simple. Because this is not a blank, above cell value plus 1, so I can simply have 2. Right? Now let me drag below. This is still 2 because it's a blank, above value. This answer is 3 because this is not a blank. This answer is still 3 because it's a blank. Thanks for the participation. Now let me drag till here it's 3. Wow. Now let me double click this. Till the end, I got the transactions. 3485 are the entries. You go to the day book, 3437 plus 25, 34, exactly the same entries you got. 3485 transactions are there in this day book. I'll just keep the formula open. Now I request everyone write the same formula in your Excel. I'm sure you understood now why I kept this cell as a blank. Because if I keep something here as doc, see, you'll get a value error. Why? Because doc plus one, text plus a number is not possible. It's a value error. That's the reason I did not keep any title here. Later, I'll keep the title. Everyone, please write this formula in your Excel. Make sure that you got the same values. I'm just giving 1 minute time, 2 minutes time rather, so you can go whatever the formula have given in the A column. Yeah, I found a question from Vinod. Should we ensure to clear the filters while dragging down the formula? It's okay if filters are active. You have to clear the filters. Because if you don't clear the filter, earlier what I did, I have selected the blank rows and I have removed. So make sure that you are clearing the filter while writing the formula, because this formula I want to write for all the cells, all the rows in the A column. So I request you to clear the filter before writing the formula. So I hope everyone completed this formula. If any question till this point, please let me know. If any question you have till this point, please let me know in the chat box. I hope I can go ahead. I just consider your silence as the acceptance. Now, friends, select this call. Copy. Control C. Don't go anywhere. You can just go to the home tab. Paste as the values, right? Just paste as the values. Otherwise, simply right click. Paste special. You'll get the pop-up values. So that I can keep the title on the top. Friends, once you remove the, once you copy and paste special as a values, your formulas will get removed. So copy, paste special values. After I have done this, if you check it out, the formulas are gone. Now let me give the title as a document number. It's a document number. Right. Now, second important step is over. First important step is creating debit and credit column. Second important step is creating the unique document number. Not only this, if I want to use this data into my pivot table, I should not have any blanks. So wherever the blanks are there, that blanks must fill with the above cell data. Before doing this, let me remove this OCHR numbers. It's not required to me. Select the E column, delete. Everyone follow along with me. Yeah, there's a question, Vaidishwaran. You want me to show the formula of this? Okay, no problem. Let me go back and show you the formula. I'll give you another 30 seconds, sir. Please complete this. Sir, confirm once you are done. Whoever missed earlier, you can also have a revision. Great. So after this formula, what I have done, I have selected this entire column, copy, I went into the paste special, I did a values. Why I did paste special values? So that formulas will disappear, values will remain. I can keep the title as a document number. I hope everyone are done till this point. After that, I have removed this voucher numbers. Select the voucher numbers column and delete. I want everyone must be on the same page because the next steps are very important. I don't want you should miss. So what I'm trying to do now from the first cell, yeah, instead of deleting rows, can we export from Tally as detail without narration? You can do that, but without even narration or anything, this is same. This formula is anywhere required. That is also fine. But in this case, narration, because this entirely the data which I have prepared, narration I have not considered, but in a real sense for the analysis purpose, narration is also required. Rajesh, sir. If we take entire data, including the narration, later if something I want to analyze the data, I can go back to the raw data, I can just analyze. That's the purpose I have taken the entire data. I hope your query is clear. I don't want to go every time back into the Tally and do the analysis. Great. Now friends, once you remove the voucher number, let me filter for the blanks. I just filter the date column, filter for the blanks. Everyone, please do the same steps. Everyone, please do the same steps. Let me do the step again. What I have done, I filtered for the date. I filtered for the date. Select the blanks. In Excel, the same thing can be done in different ways, but I'm just telling you whatever the best I feel. As you know, the same thing can be done in more than one different method. Everyone, please filter for the blanks in the date column. Now, generally the method, if I want to select till the end, because so many rows are there, it's very difficult for me to go till the end. So what method which I follow, I'll go back to the previous column. I'll do control down arrow so that I'll come to the down. I'll keep my cursor here. I'll do control shift up arrow, so that you can select the entire data. Friends, please select entire blank cells, whatever you have filtered. So to select that, either you can just select shift down arrow, down arrow, down arrow. It takes little time. Otherwise, what you can do, you can just go to the last row, keep the cursor here, control shift up arrow. I hope this technique everyone likes. Right? So what I'll be doing now after this selection, I'll just go to the home tab. I'll go to, are you finding here in the editing tab, there is an option clear eraser symbol. Friends, everyone can, let me continue this step first so that you can do it later. Let me click clear formats, or else you can do clear contents. Everyone please do clear contents. Why? Because if any unprintable, non-printable characters are there, that will get erased. So clear contents, because many a times when you take the tally data into your Excel, it looks like nothing is there, but there is some non-printable character inside. Let me do Control Z. Let me prove that it is correct. Friends, I'm just trying to write a small formula. Everyone, please concentrate this concept so that you can understand what exactly it is. I can write a small formula is blank. There is a function in Excel called is blank. Select this. Can anyone guess what is the answer here? You can put in the chat box. Is it a blank cell? The answer is true. The answer is true. Yes, it's a blank cell. Because this is a blank. Apparently also it looks like blank only. Now let me use a formula. Is blank, which one? This cell, close bracket. This is an indication that I'm just trying to check whether it's a blank cell or not. Let me enter false. That means there is something inside, right? When there is something inside, you cannot replace that. So that's the reason the best method is, let me select the entire blank area here. Let me go to the home tab. Let me click clear contents. Once you click clear content, are you finding this false turned into the true? Because whatever the non-printable characters, which is not visible for us, also got deleted. Clear contents, one of the very important step. Now friends, here what is my job? I want to fill the above data in the blank cells. There's one more question from Vinod. As there is some content in the date column, shift down arrow working in date column as well as clear content, correct? Okay, but I'm just trying to tell you different options. If it is there, then that's fine. If it is not there, okay. So as you said, if something is there, you can even do control down arrow. Control shift down arrow. But friends, non-printable characters. So I got a question, Vinod. When if it is a non-printable characters, it will not identify with the cursor. That's the problem. Right? That's a separate story. Non-printable characters in the sense of, okay, I'm a little deviating because there is a question asked by Vinod. If I use a function called car from 1, are you finding here something which is not visible? Till 13, I think if I'm not wrong, let me use a small function called row. I'm just a little deviating the topic. Please concentrate with me. No, it is still, if I'm not wrong, till 32. Oops. One second, this is 7. This is, that means 8. Okay. Yeah. Friends, till 39 are the non-printable characters. That means these all are some characters, but our system will not identify. Okay. So that is anyway different topic. In fact, I kept one video in the YouTube channel, so you can watch it later. Now, let me put an equal sign here. And also one more observation. I don't know how many of you observe. After I have selected this, this format is the text format by default. What I'm going to do, let me select this, convert into the general format. Convert into the general format, because while keeping this into the text format, if I write the formula, while keeping this into the text format, if I write the formula, my formula will remain same. It will not convert into a value. Now let me put equal sign. Above cell value is B2. Let me put B2. You can type it because you cannot select that because that is got hidden. So equal to B2 value will come here. Because it's a relative reference, I can use a shortcut Control plus Enter. Control plus Enter shortcut is I want to paste the same formula in the entire selected area. Control the center. Wow. Let me do all the steps whoever missed for very quickly. Friends, let me do the steps. This after written the formula, I did copy paste special value in the A column. Then I came to my date column. Then I filtered for the blanks. I'm sorry. Let me filter for the blanks. Click OK. Now I have selected this entire data. I went into the clear contents. I went here and I have converted this into the general format. After that, I have taken equal sign into the active cell. Then I have written B2 as a cell reference. Then without entering, normally after we write the formula, we click enter. I don't want to enter now. I do control enter. Control plus enter is the shortcut which can select into the visible cells. Now, let me explain. You can just keep your cursor at 4-5 places. You write 100 here. Though it looks like you are writing 100 here, but since I have selected so many cells, if you normally click enter, it will go to the next cell. Now, let me 100 here. Now, I am not doing enter. I'll do control plus enter. Once you do control plus enter, the same value will appear everywhere. That is the same technique I followed here. Now, if you remove the filter, go to the data tab, remove the filter, check it out. Here, about two cells value. This is second transaction, second day. This is entirely second day. This is the third day and so on. I request everyone, please complete this formula, right? Everyone, please select this data. Write this formula, control plus enter. Don't enter, control plus enter. I'll give you 1 minute to 2 minutes time in this point. At this step, I'm giving you 2 minutes time. Please complete. Yeah, it seems there are a couple of questions by Sai Manikanta and Ramakrishna. It's very simple. Let me delete this. Friends, I've just selected this entire area. I hope everyone did the same. You simply type it equal to B2. Because I know that above this cell is a B2 which is having a date. Control plus enter. How to go to the first cell? Shortcut you are asking, it is control plus home. If you want to go to the first cell, control plus home. You can use the tab. Okay, I got your point. If you are into the last cell, use the tab so that you will go into the next cell. So I did control plus enter. Now clear the filter, stop everyone for 1 minute. Now I'm going to do the same for voucher type. Very quickly I'm doing. So I'll just go to the voucher type. Everyone please stop and watch. I request everyone please stop and watch. Let me select the blanks for the voucher. Right, the same thing I'm doing. Go to the previous cell, control down arrow, select from here, control shift up arrow. Right, if you want to go to the first cell, tab. Right, so what I need to do, I need to go to the home tab. I should clear the contents, then I should go to the format. Let me keep it as a general. Let me put equal sign. Let me put D2, control enter. Yeah, Saimanikanta, if it is giving you 12247, it's going to 12247. I think you are not deleted the. Seems you have selected the entire column. You please follow my steps again. Friends, I'm repeating the same step. Now go back to the previous step, previous column, control down arrow. It is into 12247. Keep the cursor here, control shift up arrow. Shift down so that I don't want any first cell. Now use the tab while in the selection. Now equal to D2. Control enter. Please press tab. If the active cell is 12 last cell of the column, then you use tab from your keyboard that will take you to the first cell. Please everyone fill the voucher types also below. Please fill the voucher types also below. Now my job is over. I can simply clear the filter. I can just go to the data tab. Let me clear the filter. Everyone just go to the data tab, click clear so that everything appeared. Now this is the working file. Don't worry, I'll give you a little time. Okay. After you all did these steps, insert a new sheet. I request you to insert a new sheet. Keep the sheet name as day book. This is the proper day book on which I'm going to do analysis. Day book. Go to the working file. Keep the cursor in the A1 cell. Control shift right arrow. Control shift down. Otherwise, control shift end. But instead, you can do control shift right arrow, control shift down arrow. Keep the cursor here. Control shift right arrow, control shift down arrow. So that this entire area will get selected. Let me do control C. Go to the day book. Just now, whatever you inserted. Now you can do paste special value. You can right click, paste special, click values. Otherwise, go to the home tab, paste. You can click this, paste special values. complete till this step. Then you can simply put, just select all the columns. You can put any of the between any of the two columns, just double click so that it will auto fit. Just select the first row, keep the formatting, keep the border. And because I did paste special values, this date will turn into the number. Select this date, convert into the short date format. These all are small, small steps. I'm sure you can easily follow. Then select the last three columns. It's always good practice if you have a comma format with zero decimals. Now this data will give us a lot of inferences. Now I request you to insert one more sheet. I request you to insert one more sheet. GL list. I want to get all the ledger accounts used during the year. Insert the new sheet called GL list. Please insert the new sheet called GL list. Simple. Now you just copy from here till the end, Control C. I request everyone to copy these particulars. Go to the GL list, paste from A to cell. Copy the day book particulars, all the GLs, paste into GL list sheet so that I'll have a unique values. Once you pasted, go to the data tab, remove the duplicates. I'm sure you'll find here an option called remove duplicates. Once I click remove duplicates, click OK. 207 items are remained. That means throughout the year, the company has used 207 unique ledger accounts. I'm doing this step again. Friends, after the day work, I'm sure you all changed the formatting of the date. Earlier it was into the number, serial number formatting. After that, select all these three columns, keep the comma format, zero decimals. After that, I asked you to insert one more sheet. Please call the sheet as a GL list. Everyone, please keep the same sheet names so that you will go along with me. Now go to the day book, select all the ledgers, Control C, go to the GL list, you can paste here. Now go to the data, Are you finding your remove duplicates? Click remove duplicates, click OK. So that 12,039 duplicate values found and removed, 207 unique values are remaining. Now you can just give the title as GL name. This is the title. I'm sorry. This is the title, GL name. Friends, don't worry. This video will be again in the same YouTube channel. You can play it again after the session if you think you missed any of the steps. And also this working file, I'll be uploading it to the same website, same URL immediately after the session so that you can download it. So this GL list is the master. Wonderful. Now come back to the day book. I'll just give you 1 minute time till here. Please complete. In the meanwhile, my only request, whoever not yet subscribed to the channel, I request you to subscribe. Whoever had to like the video, I request you to like. Whoever had to join into the Telegram group, I have already shared the link in the comment section. You can join into our Telegram group, one of the very active group. Every day we keep so much. Every day we keep a lot of material there, including the quiz, including the 1 minute snippets, including the content in a more logical way. If you had to like the video or this live session, you please like it. It is just a request. Great. Now, friends, this is the data on which we can do the analysis. Analysis is possible by using the pivot table and so on. Now let me select this entire data. How to select this entire data? Keep the cursor at the top, Control Shift right arrow, Control Shift down arrow. Select the entire data. Please select the entire data. I'm sure you can use pivot table. You can use the shortcut or else go to the insert. Everyone, please go to the insert, click pivot table. It has given me the selection, whatever the range I have selected. It is saying, do you want to keep the pivot table in the new worksheet? Let this selection as it is. Just click OK. Don't do anything. Just click OK. Now I can keep this as a last sheet. Okay, or else besides the ebook, you can move. Generally, the pivot table sheet is before your raw data. I request you to keep the sheet after the raw data. Right? Friends, I did nothing. I just selected this data. I went into the insert. I clicked pivot table. After I clicked pivot table, it has taken me into the new sheet. Once you keep the cursor into this pivot table layout, you'll find extra two tabs. And also by default, one more pane appeared, that is pivot table fields. Mistakenly, if you close this pivot table fields, you can go to the pivot table analyze, click the field list. Or else you can just right click on this layout, click the show field list. Field list, all the fields you can find. There are four items here, filters, columns, rows, values. These all are different parts which I can use in the pivot table. I'm sure till here everyone are done. Now, let me take my document number and drag it into the rows. Please do it along with me. Take the document number, keep it into the rows. Besides that, please keep the date and keep after the document number in the same rows. No problem. It will give you something like a grouping. What I'll be doing, right click and group. Please go along with me. After that, also please keep the particulars after the date. Also please keep the voucher type after the particulars. If you observe, there are four items I kept one below other into the row section. You'll get to know a little later what I'm going to do with this. Now, keep the debit in the values. Keep the credit also into the values. keep the debit or credit also into the values. Just close this field list for the time being. Friends, everyone, please do all these steps. There's a question. Please repeat the step for deletion duplicate. Sir, for the deletion of the duplicate, what I have followed, friends, I'm just giving a break here because there's a question. Friends, I inserted a new sheet called GL list. Then what I have done, I went into the daybook. I just copied this daybook data. Then I went into the GL list. I pasted here. Then let me go to the data tab. Let me click here, delete duplicates. Once I click OK, all the duplicates got deleted. 207 remained. 207 remained. I hope your doubt clarified. After that, I went into the daybook. I selected the entire data. Then I moved document number, date, particulars, voucher type into the rows. Then debit, credit, and debit or credit into the values. Once you are done with this, you can just close this pivot table fields. But I am giving you the time you to complete this. Please complete this step. Please complete this step. Okay, so after this, I can go into the design tab. Everyone, please go into the design tab. Report layout. I want to keep this into the tabular form because by default it's a compact form. I want to keep this into a tabular form. Don't worry, it looks like first column is a little bigger. Just double click this. Friends, I did nothing. Let me repeat the steps. I went into the design tab. I went into the report layout. Let me click show in tabular form. Just select all the columns. You can keep the cursor anywhere between two columns. Double click so that it will auto filter. Right? I'm sure everyone have done till here. Now what I'll be doing, I'll select the last three columns. I'll keep the comma format zero decimals. But this pivot table is not looking very nice because subtotals is there every step. So what I'll do, I'll go to design again. I will go to the subtotal. I'll click don't show the subtotal. Don't show the subtotals. Right, then I want to have a subtotal only for the document. Right click, give the subtotal for the document number so that this properly came as an entry. Anytime later, I can analyze this data properly. Right, if you want, you can have a blank row. If you want, you can change the pivot table, how it has to look like. Maybe I can just change this into this format so that each entry you can find it whenever you want to cross check whether this entry, how it is coming and so on, you can come back. No problem. This is only just for the analysis. So let me keep day book in pivot table PT. Let me rename the sheet as a day book in PT. Let me do the steps very quickly. Control Z, Control Z, Control Z, Control Z, Control Z. I'm just doing Control Z. Okay, till here, I'm sure everyone did earlier. Whoever missed the steps, please follow. I went into the design. I just changed this report into the tabular form. Then I've selected all these three columns. I kept into the comma format with zero decimals. Then I went into the design. Then I removed the subtotals. I selected all the columns. I just did auto fit. Then I right click document number. Then I clicked the subtotal because I want only the subtotal for the document. Then I changed this format into some other nice format like this. Okay, this is daybook in PT. PT is something, a pivot table. This is for the better understanding for the analysis. Right? Now, friends, let me have, because this data, now let's say I am from the auditor angle. I've taken this data, I did formatting and everything in a proper shape. Now I want to allocate, because there are 3,485 transactions are there. I want my staff has to audit this. So I should give some sample to them. So what I'll be doing, now let me insert one more sheet. Keep this sheet as a last sheet, maybe here. Keep this name as a sampling. Keep this name as a sampling, right? So doc numbers. How many doc numbers I have? 3,485. So what I'll be doing, I'll keep one, I'll keep two. Now you can simply drag till 3,485. Let me very quickly drag it. 3,485. Right? So I am almost done. 3,485. Saran, is there any better option instead of dragging like here till here? Simple. You can just go back to your daybook, select this entire column, copy, you go to your sample, paste here, do the same step, go to the data, remove the duplicates. So that all duplicates got removed, 3,485 document numbers are here. I request you to complete this step. Because I have to allocate, let's say I have four staff, I have to allocate 50 document numbers to each staff. So that at least 200 documents I need to verify and analyze. Now, no problem. You can take the time. You can take time, no problem. I'll give you another 2 minutes. Date is not coming. Sir, where date is not coming, Ajay Kumar? Date is maybe coming into year, month, and so on, is it? If that is the case, right click on the date and group. Right click on the date and ungroup. Friends, I am giving you 1 minute time till here. So I request everyone, please complete all the steps, whatever you missed. Insert a new sheet called sampling. Take all the document numbers, starts from one till the end. I have four staff who are going to work on this. Let me keep the name as Saran Kumar, one staff. Let me give one more name. I'm taking my friend name, Ajay Kumar. Please don't mind Mr. Ajay. I've just taken as an example. One more name, I'll take Mr. Maruti Gandhi. I can take one more name as I can take Mr. Vijay Srinivas. Four staff. Now my job is I should give the data of this daybook extract for all the four staff. Let me take first name, Mr. Sharan Kumar. Right? What is that? Sample. So what are the documents he has to consider? It's very simple. So you can have serial number. You can have sample document number. Keep two columns. This is a Saran Kumar sample. This all can act as a documentation also later, right? You, as you know, documentation is most important these days. If you maintain the documentation in a good way, that means you are reducing your risk as an auditor. So I want to have 50 items. So just select two, just drag it till 50, because I want for each staff should take 50 vouchers. Now, what are those documents? It's very simple. Equal to random between. What is the last document number 3485, right? Equal to random between 123485. I have written a small formula. I request everyone to understand this. From 1 till 3485, I want Excel to take randomly. Right? So some random document number is going to provide. Enter. Copy, paste till the end, right? Everyone, please look into the formula. I have written a small formula, random between 1, 3485. I may take 10 to 15 minutes extra today's session. Please bear with me. Sorry for the inconvenience because I'm going very slow. So it's taking a little more time. So enter. So just double click this so that you will get your data. Then what I need to do, go to the paste special as a values so that this random values will turn into the constants. Space salary. Now you can just copy this data, control C, you can just paste here, right? Please concentrate. Now I just copy pasted the data here. This is the sample. Now I want to get those vouchers here. That means those all transactions I should keep here. Everyone please concentrate. I did nothing. I have created a separate sheet for Saran. So I just copy pasted the data here. Now what is my job? I want to extract all these document numbers data here so that this sheet I can send to Saran, so that Saran can analyze this data, maybe from the day book tally, or he can directly go into the tally, or he can seek for the documentation. He can do whatever he want, whatever the style of the audit is having. But how to extract only these document number related entries? It's very simple. We have a beautiful function called VLOOKUP. What I will be doing, I will go to the day book. I'll go to the last column. I'll keep a cursor here. I'll keep Saran as a name. Okay. So let me keep it in the yellow color so that you can understand it's a new column. Now, this is what my document number. Everyone, please concentrate. This is a very important step. Right? So now I'm going to write a small VLOOKUP function. Please complete till here, everyone. Keep the sample data, put into a new sheet called Saran sample. These all documents, data I should extract from the daybook. So what is the step I'm going to follow? Let me go to the daybook. I kept the title as a Saran equal to a very simple function we have called VLOOKUP. VLOOKUP, what value I should look for? Look for this value, comma, where is my table in which I want to look? Go to the Saran sample Saran rather. From here, select till the last row. How to go to the last row? Control shift down here. B3 colon B52. Give F4. F4 will give you the dollar symbols. Comma. First, let me complete the formula so that you can understand later. You can practice later. First, let me complete the formula. After the formula, I'll give you 1 or 2 minutes time. So let me repeat the formula again. Equal to VLOOKUP. I want to look for this value where, go to the seventh sample from B2, B3 till the last. How to go to the last cell? Control shift down arrow. So that from B3 till the last cell are selected. Control shift down arrow. Let me give the shortcut F4. F4 shortcut will give the dollar symbols for this range. Now comma. If the value of A2 is available into this column, which column you want to get as an answer? The same column, because only one column is there in this table array. Give 1, I want to look for an exact match, 0, close bracket, enter. NA means one is not there in the table. That's the meaning of it. Everyone, please have a look into this formula. Let me decode this formula. Look for this value in this table, only one column. If it is available, the same column you please display. One means the column number out of the table. Since only one column is there, the same column I want. Range lookup 0 means it's an exact match. That means if it is available exactly, then only display, otherwise ignore. NA means it's not there. Now just select this, double click, so that the same formula copy pasted everywhere. Right now, let me filter this, select this entire data, go to the data tab, give the filter. Now filter for other than NA. That means wherever the values are available, the meaning is these all are the 7 samples. Now what I can simply do, control shift right arrow, control shift down arrow, so that I can select the visible cells. You can do control C. You can go back to the sample 7 sheet, keep the cursor here, control V. So auto fit the column width. So select all the columns, just double click. The last column I don't want, delete. Wonderful. This is what the sample for the 7. So I'll send the sheet to Saran. He will do the analysis in his own way, looking into the documents, looking into the narration, looking into whatever the different methods he can follow. Quickly, let me do for the second staff. I'll not do for all the staff. Let me do for the second staff, Ajay Kumar. So I'll simply do the same. Control C, Control V. I don't want to have a document number. So this name is Ajay Kumar, right? Let me have equal to rank between. So what is the last item? 3, 4, 8, 5. So equal to rank between 1, 3, 4, 8, 5. Close bracket, copy and paste. Right? Now let me insert, Now copy this, paste special value. Friends, I'm going a little faster because this is a very common step we need to do. Whatever I have done for the 7, the same steps I'm repeating. I need to do copy paste special values. Otherwise, these all values will keep on changing. I don't want these values to change. So copy paste special values. Wonderful. Now what I'll be doing, I insert one more sheet called sample Ajay. I can just keep sample space Ajay. Then I'll copy this entire data, control C. I can simply go here, paste. Now I want to get the Ajay data here. So what I need to do, go to the daybook, go to the, remove the filters here, put the filter here, keep one more column Ajay. Let me give it a different color. Right? Yeah, there's a question. Sir, if we generate more samples by Excel formula to allocate to each staff, will Excel may repeat the same random numbers which it generates earlier? That is possible. There may be a possible, maybe the same document number may be there for 2 people. If that is the case, what I can do, I can simply use a VLOOKUP function here so that I can check it out whether anything is getting repeated. Okay. After this, the method which I follow, I'll copy all these samples one below other. I'll allocate a name. In fact, very recently I made one video on the same topic, how to allocate the names by using the VLOOKUP function. Then I'll remove all the duplicate. I'll check it out all the duplicates so that I get to know. Yeah, in Ajay's column, if we do rand between, would we not same get the same document number given to Saran ma'am? That's what I'm exactly covering here. After this entire story, what I will be doing, first let me complete this Ajay's one, then I can explain. I can explain the same. I can go to the daybook. Okay. I can have a VLOOKUP function, VLOOKUP, then look for this value, comma, go to the sample Ajay, select this data, F4, comma, 1, comma, 0, the same formula, whatever I have given earlier, the same formula I have given here, copy, paste below. Now put the filters for Ajay. Select everything other than NA. Wonderful. Copy this data. Go to the Ajay. Paste here. After I do this entire job, I'll keep everything one below other. Now, all samples. Right? I can just keep all samples. This is Saran, right? So let me do control. There are different methods you can follow. This is one method I feel. So this is document number. I can keep the name as a Saran for this. And this is the document number. I'll paste here. I'll keep the name as a Ajay. Now friends, what I'll be doing, I can keep all the samples one below other. I'll select this data. I'll go to my home tab. I will go to the conditional formatting. I'll go to the conditional formatting. I'll highlight the cells based on the duplicate values. Let me click OK. Now you do one thing. Select this data, filter, give the filters, filter by color. See, check it out. 1442 got repeated for Ajay itself. And 2392 got repeated for Ajay itself. 560 is there for both the people. So wherever 560 is there, I will change it. So I hope you all got the point. There are different ways we can do the same. So once you get all the documents, you can keep everything one below other so that you can just remodify this. You can just change the name here and so on. There is one more question. Or can we initially generate the samples for all staff? Yes. Yes, you can do that. You can initially generate the samples for all the staff. You can keep everything one below other. You can adjust all these things. Later, you can extract the data. Any method we can follow. You are absolutely correct, Mr. Vinod. Severin, ma'am, I hope you got the point. See, if we use the Power Query, in fact, I thought of giving one small video for the next week on the Power Query, if time permits. Okay. So in the Power Query, these all transformations can be done. These all logics we can build. Okay. But anyway, so I hope you all understood this concept. So I can have the staff data one after other. Then I can start analyzing this data. This staff can have a remarks here and he can start putting his remarks, everything one below other. This is the way we can analyze the data. Probably we can segregate the data among the staff and we can do some analysis out of this. Since our time is already 12:40, I'm just stopping here. But before stopping this, I'll just try to give you a small conceptual understanding with respect to the cash related analysis. Because in the tax audit, this is one thing which is very important. So friends, please concentrate. So what I want to do, I want to extract all the vouchers where cash is part, all the documents where cash is part. I hope you all are getting my point. Can you please put in the chat box your idea how to extract only the cash related transactions? Anyone? See, I want to do some analysis with respect to only cash related vouchers. If I want to do the analysis with respect to cash related vouchers, first I have to extract all the cash related transactions out. I have a small methodology, don't worry. What I'll do, I'll just filter here for cash in the day book. Friends, please concentrate. These all are the documents with respect to cash. Let me copy this, Control C. Let me insert a new sheet, paste, Control V, right? These all are cash related transactions. So cash transactions, right? These all are relating to the cash related transactions. Let me select this. I'm 100% sure you will not have a duplicate because every transaction will have only one line item that may be cash. Let me click OK, no duplicates found. That means these all transactions data I should get here. So what I'll be doing, the same VLOOKUP function. Now let me remove the filter. I can just have your cash transactions. Then I can put a VLOOKUP function, look for this value, comma, go to the sheet 10, select this entire area. Let me click F4, comma, 1, comma, 0, enter, copy, and paste. That means wherever you found the values, those all are the cash. If I want to extract those cash values, what I need to do? Select the cash portion, deselect any. Now you just copy this entire data, paste here. These all are the cash related vouchers. Okay. Let me put cash transactions. I hope everyone understood. Methodology is same. You can follow in different ways. Okay. Voucher type filter. Yes. That is also correct. But yeah, you are correct, ma'am. Voucher type filter is also one of the method. We can go ahead. Or if this is one of the method, I think that's the best method. But it has given as a payment. And the receipt, both vouchers may have the same cash. And sometimes we may have bank also along with that. I hope you get my point. So I want to take only the cash, right? So that's the reason I have not gone into the voucher type. I went into the documentation. Now what I will be doing, let me copy this entire data. Paste special values here. Now what I'm going to do? Remove the duplicates, click here, remove the duplicates. Okay, these all are the different vouchers we have used, different GLs we have used for cash. Now you have a cash sales and a lot of other things are there. My point is when you have a ledger called, for example, ABC, then you can have all the dates of ABC with respect to cash. If it is available, then you can put simply a SUMIF function so that on a particular day for the particular person, is there anything excess more than 10,000 or put together on the day more than 2 lakhs for a person and so on. You can do a lot of analysis. So like this, you can have different GL separately and you can start analyzing the transactions. Friends, it's already 12:45. I've taken 15 minutes excess. Last 15 to 20 minutes, I went a little faster, but the steps are same. Okay, so as it is the same file, I'll be uploading into the same website. I request you to download this and practice. So next week, we'll come with a different case study. We'll go a little elaborate what I'll do because it's only the experience for me also. Than first week, I feel this week the topic is little elaborate. So I've taken a little more time. Probably it looks like I went a little faster. Next week, I'll come with a PDF where all steps are pre-filled so that I'll also share the steps with you so that even if I miss one step, you can look into the PDF and you can do along with me. Okay, guys, thank you so much and see you all in the next week. If you want me to cover a specific topic, you can put in the comment section so that I can look into those topics. I can make a material. I can cook up some data. And I will come into the next week. So next week, Thursday, 11 a.m. See you all. Thank you so much. Please subscribe the channel if you did not till now. Please join into our Telegram group. See you in the next Thursday. Bye-bye.